Last year, I had uploaded a single video on this plant. Then I had no idea about the plant. It was total new to my garden. Then after going through some books and Google search, I found the name to be peacock ginger. Friends, a very short note on classification. The plant belongs to the family Zingiberaceae, genus Campharia. It looks similar to the genus Calathea, but Calathea has the family Marantaceae. However, plant classification is a vast chapter, better not get into it. These are the new leaves growing from the base. No stem is found. Let me tell you about the soil type. Use very porous soil. I used leaf compost, much amount of sand, neem extract, charcoal chips and fungicide powder. I have taken a wide shallow pot. Choosing pot for growing plants is a vital factor. These are the rhizomes. They spread laterally on the soil. They never go underneath the soil. Do not try to push them inside the soil. Let the plant grow in its own way. As the leaf mature, from each leaf a single violet color flower bloom every day, and the flower persists for a single day. Friends, I want to tell you, I have a delicate attachment towards this plant. The plant was on fire last October. Some fire sparks fell on the plant while welding iron. We were making our tin shed above the terrace, and all leaves had caught fire. I had lost all hope, but I kept the tuber or rhizome under the soil, somehow if it can sprout later. And finally, to my surprise, I found it sprouting this year in the month of February. Commonly, the plant is known as peacock ginger as it resembles the peacock feather. This one was the first leaf growth. The crow came and pecked the plant, the enemy of my garden, and even destroyed my orchid. Friends, have a look upon the leaves. They are wide and have lovely designs. I love to see the leaves and spend my time over here. There are some plants in my garden which fascinate me a lot. I am looking for more species of Campharia, and the different species have different flowers, rarely found in plant nurseries. Okay friends, now let us discuss on the required conditions of the plant. Keep the plant under shade. It loves filtered sunlight. Never keep under direct sunlight. Loves too much of humidity. The plant cannot withstand too high temperature. Now about the watering of the plant. Water less, avoid overwatering. Area with high temperature, water twice daily. Try to keep the soil moist but not wet. Do not water over the leaves, but less humidity zone can mist once a week. I always say that watering of your plants depend upon the climatic condition of your city. Now about the propagation of the plant. I have not yet propagated. Let the plant grow larger. We'll do it later. The plant multiply itself during monsoon. You can separate the rhizome and they will multiply. A large shallow pot will help the plant to multiply faster. Winter season, all leaves dry and shed. But do not worry friends, again they will sprout by the spring and they will grow. No pest attack found in this plant. Usually caterpillars attack these plants and swallow the leaves, but not in my case. That was all about peacock ginger. If you have liked this video, then like, share and comment. Subscribe to my channel and stay connected. We'll help you out on gardening as much as I can. Lots of love from Garden Hill. Bye bye. Stay happy, stay healthy.